Hello everyone, I'm Huan. Welcome to follow the camera of Huan Xingji, a happy journey. This is Qiangtou Town, Xiangshan County. Finally, it's the grain drying season in Qiangtou Town. Look at this grain drying ground. Golden rice is spread all over, shining like a scattered gold under the sun, and the wind carries the fresh scent of just harvested rice ears. This is the most healing scene of autumn, and today I will take you to experience the traditional skill of drying grain. Let's go! 阿姨，养了个啥瓜？啊？搿是啥秀啊？搿是老虎嘛？分享啊！哇！哈哈哈哈！
搿哇！啊！搿有多少年数了？搿只东西？哦，
阿在哪？
有几十年有了吧？
哦，我感激我也你搞的我钱都干嘛好想我
是我
Drying grain isn't just spreading rice out, there is a skill to it. Look at the wooden rake in the farmer's hand. They have to turn the rice evenly from time to time, so every grain gets sunlight, which prevents the rice from getting moldy. Let me try this movement. Hold the rake handle with both hands. Push it gently to one side, and the rice turns over. The damp rice getting more through sun drying. The farmer said that since the sun's angle is different in the morning and the afternoon, we also need to adjust the direction of turning the rice to ensure even heating. These are all experiences passed down from generation to generation.
You did from here.
Ah, you got from here, take you
to. You did from here, too.
You got from here, take you to.
You did from here, too, man.
Cause you took a yellow league.
You take it.
Well, you're this aqua.
How to tell if the rice is fully dried? The traditional method relies on looking, touching, and rubbing. First, look at the color. Fully dried rice is brighter. Then, touch it. Dry rice feels cool and not sticky. The most important step is rubbing. Grab a handful of rice and rub it in your palm.If the huskers fall off easily and the exposed rice grains are plump and hard, it means the rice is fully dried. This is one of the secrets to the good taste of Qiangtou Town's rice. Every grain is carefully screened by the sun.
After experiencing grain drying today, I truly understand the meaning of every grain is hard earned. From harvesting in the paddy field to drying and turning on the ground, every step requires patience and care. Autumn in Qiangtou Town not only has beautiful mountains and rivers, but also such lively farming scenes full of life.If you come here in autumn, be sure to visit the grain drying ground. Maybe you can even help the farmers turn a rake of rice and feel this most authentic joy of harvest.
Watch a kick, go go, like a joshua. A bang, like joshua! Huh? Young, like joshua?
我种萝卜。
萝卜。
哎。
哦。
萝卜啦。
萝卜。
哎。土萝卜嘛，土嘞让我们修好，才把热死了没有？
嗯。我说你
跟着奶奶去种地。
我来之前。
种哪朵？
我不能。
哦。你都这月子
去了的这个了，我没好过。
哦，干多。
早上为什么在这干起来哇？
昨日种的，我种了里头嘞，剩了个个。
哦，种起来。
里头一只死了嘞，我到了里头种了起个。
哦。个毛啊！
嗯。
个白白个啥些哇？就是复合肥啊。
哎，复合肥。
哦，不叫复合肥。个么几老个地，人要几老个菜？
哎，个昨日种了个么就跟不上出，个么是几老的就哇。
个几米一年不生出来？
太阳我就生了个快，我母脚我又几个。
哈哈哈！
哈，夜了么出老的就嘞。
哦，干嘛了？
露丝的就羞羞的个。
嗯。
嗯。
露丝的就滋润的哦。
哎。
干嘛了？阿爸，我那个做什么？
我种萝卜哇，我要种多少萝卜？
养也种萝卜。
啊。
养啊，那个萝卜。
多多菜。
多多菜啊。
嗯。
哦，这是大头菜。哎。
啊嘞。到了到坡就下。
大爷说呢，现在这片荒草呢全部除掉，然后呢就种上可爱的白萝卜，对不对？
啊。
嗯。
种萝卜。
阿爸，给你打听去看，这个草莓哇，这个无土栽培的草莓到阿都谁我讲的？
啥个草莓啊？
无土的，它就是没有土的，它就是。
哦，没有土豆的。
没有土的草莓。
大概上面搞了上面。
对
对
对对
对，
草莓，草莓。
在那边那个华阳公司那个就是梅花公司里。
哦，搿都是呀。
啊，大板。
对个，它叫梅梅果园。
都搁了上面里。
对对对对对。
嗯。是华阳公司，这个个在那边的，这个盖里下面到海山区不是？海山区这个地方。
哦。
就是梅的公司。
哦，搿都是有一片草莓的。
一片大板。
哦，我去看看哦。
嗯，那搁了上面里的。
对的对的。
做盆子嘛。
哎，盆子个嘛个，它的草莓。可以往上走的那个，一把一把的哦，
一把一把的，
这个对个、
嗯。
好，我去看看。
你去看了。
哎，洋洋哥。
嗯。
哇，这里能走过来吗？这好像走不过来吗？
边上走过来。
As I stepped into this smart greenhouse, I was amazed by the scene in front of me. Rows of strawberry planting troughs are actually floating in the air, and the green strawberry seedlings are growing vigorously. This is the Aero Strawberry Intelligent Cultivation Mode we are going to experience today. Doesn't it feel like walking into a future farm? Look!The technicians are giving the strawberry seedlings a health check. They carefully remove the old and diseased leaves. I just consulted Mr. Zhu Caifang, the technical instructor. He said that removing these leaves in time can not only help the strawberry seedlings differentiate flower buds better, but also reduce nutrient waste, keeping each seedling in the best growth state.
现在这个是空中草莓，它可以升降的，你看，可以随时的每个排、每个盆、每个排都可以升下降，就是草莓成熟的时候，我们下面可以长情喝茶、喝咖啡啊，场景都非常漂亮。上面可以草莓挂下来，啊，比如你要采哪颗，我就把哪条放下来，可以采摘，很方便。
The most interesting part is here. The biggest difference between this aerial strawberry and the traditional elevated cultivation is these freely liftable planting troughs. Mr. Zhu demonstrated it for us on the spot. Just touch this switch lightly, and the planting trough can be adjusted freely between 80 centimeters and 3 meters in height.Let me have a try. Press the lower button. The trough slowly comes down, and I can reach the strawberry seedlings with my hand. From now on, there is no need to stand on tiptoes or bend over for picking or daily management. It's so convenient.
风机是它主要是空气流通，促进空气流通。它我这边水帘一打开，比方说我外面36、37度，我这里可以控制到30度以内。
In fact, this smart greenhouse has more high-tech features than just the liftable troughs. It is the first aerial strawberry planting place in Xiangshan County, covering an area of about 6 mu. There are many advanced equipment hidden inside. The intelligent constant temperature system can keep the temperature in the greenhouse stable. The automatic integrated water and fertilizer machine accurately waters and fertilizes the strawberry seedlings. And
there is also an intelligent environment monitor that keeps an eye on indicators such as humidity and light at all times.
加水嘛，你看它这个滴管是反冲式滴管，它是每20公分一颗一个孔。它说我们可以精确到我这个植物要多少营养加营养，我多少水分，我可以精确计算。我这里滴几分钟，比方5分钟，我能达到200克的水。那我就滴五分钟，这样我可以精确到每颗的那个水分嘛。手机带也能控制啊，我现在只要点开外这样展开，它就是这个黑的，慢慢就会展开。
Mr. Zhu said that the configuration of this greenhouse is currently the highest level in the county. The greenhouse is 6.5 meters high with an external sunshade net, an internal thermal insulation layer, as well as fans and water curtains. Air conditioners will be added later, so precise temperature control will be achieved throughout the year. In such a thoughtful environment, the disease resistance and growth of strawberries are naturally very good.
好先进啊！
一个人就可以管理整个农场了。
我们一个人，像我一个人管，我们有管七个农场。
Besides the convenient operation, this mode also saves a lot of space. Mr. Zhu did a quick calculation for me. When the planting troughs are not in use, lift them to a high place, and the lower place can be used for research trips and team building. Moreover, on the same move of land, traditional elevated cultivation can only plant 7 rows of strawberries, but now it can plant up to 9 rows. That's a 30% increase. Look at the empty lower space now. It will be perfect for kids to experience farming or companies to hold activities in the future. No space is wasted at all.
像这种这个品种的话，亩产能做到商品果亩产能做到3000到5000斤，就一亩地。我们这个草莓一般要再卖到60到80块一斤，那么像白的，基本卖到100到150块一斤。
Today's experience at Mei Mei Orchard is really surprising. From the strawberry seedlings floating in the air to the smart equipment all over the greenhouse, I truly feel that Xiangshan's strawberry industry is developing towards intelligence and intensification. This aero strawberry mode not only makes farming easier and more efficient, but also provides an excellent example for the transformation and upgrading of modern agriculture. If you are also curious about smart agriculture, you can come to Xiangshan next time. Maybe you can see more new tricks of agricultural technology. Thank you so much for joining me on this adventure in Xiangshan. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more amazing travel experiences. I love reading your comments, so feel free to leave your thoughts below. Until next time, stay curious and keep exploring. Bye-bye!